From 12 News, this is Weekend Today.
And it's time to start filing your taxes. This morning, we're making it easier for you to get the biggest return possible. Tax tips from an expert whose goal is to get you back the most money. Well, you may not want to hear this, but it's tax time. You can start filing your taxes now. A lot of people put it off, but here with us this morning is Shauna Weckerlein of Tax Goddess Express. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Very good.
Let's try to make this easy. What recommendations do you have?
So one of the most important things you can do for yourself to lower your tax bill is stay organized. Throughout the year, you're going to have lots of different types of things that are deductible, like medical expenses, property tax payments, even if you purchased a new car or a large TV, the sales tax. Those types of items normally people forget when it comes around to tax time. So if you keep a record throughout the year, it makes it much easier to get organized for the end.
Okay, and tuition as well?
Absolutely. Yeah, of course, a big thing, you know, lots of kids going off to college. You also have children that are in private schools. Not that the tuition for the private school is a deduction, but the state of Arizona actually has three credits where when you pay a dollar, you get a dollar back. And private schools, public schools can both count for those.
Oh, very interesting.
Absolutely.
And you told me some people actually forget to tell their tax preparer about having a new baby.
Absolutely. You'd figure that would be something you don't forget. But often what happens, you get to tax time, everybody doesn't quite like taxes, it's a little scary. So we've actually had clients forget to tell us they have a child. A child can be almost a $2,000 deduction on your tax return. So definitely want to tell us about kids.
Okay, so something else you have on this list here, you have charity donations.
Absolutely. So we talked about public school, private school, but the other one that actually works as a credit is the working poor. So if you donate money to any of those three charities, you give in a dollar, you get a dollar back, and you get money off on your federal. So it's one of those rare cases where you're actually making money on the government, which is awesome. So.
All right, so let's talk about some lesser known medical deductions.
So some of these are my favorite. Medical is one of those areas where everyone's confused. You know about your doctor's visits, maybe your dentist, glasses, but some of the more rare ones, did you know that if your doctor tells you you need a pool to help you with arthritis, to be able to work out, your entire pool can be deductible. Things like breast augmentation, depending on what you do for a living. There's all sorts of very strange things. So one of the most important things, make sure that you're checking with your doctor and of course checking with your CPA as to whether they're going to be deductible for you.
All right, and something else, acupuncture? I had no idea.
Absolutely. Acupuncture, acupressure, the IRS has actually gotten into a lot of the Eastern medicines as well. So again, as long as your doctor says this is something that's going to help you and you need it, it's deductible.
Is that fairly new?
In the past couple of years,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Huh.
Gym memberships, of course, being the other big one. With gym memberships, again, a lot of people these days are trying to lose weight. And if your doctor has prescribed that you need to lose weight to maybe control your cholesterol or your blood pressure, gym membership can be deductible.
Wow. So I guess you have to have some kind of proof that you do need these things, right?
Absolutely. You always, always want to make sure that your doctor is writing his recommendations in your file. So if the IRS ever asks, you can get the file from the doctor, provide it to the IRS.
Okay, very nice. A lot of helpful information here this morning. Tell us one more question. What is the most common deduction people overlook?
Biggest one that I've ever seen is the sales tax on new purchases. Especially when somebody buys a new car, your sales tax is almost 10% here in Arizona. So if you've bought a $20,000 car, that's a $2,000 deduction that people completely forget.
Wow, incredible. Well, thank you so much, Shauna. And for more information, you can go to taxgoddess.com. You've got a blog on there with all sorts of helpful information.
Absolutely.
Thanks for coming in this
morning.
Thanks
for having me.